song's called Harrison Ford.
K-19, the Widowmaker. Do you know you're one heartbreaker? Harrison Ford, my adored. I would help you choose the grill. All other actors seem to pale in comparison to Harrison Ford. I'd wait 6 days and 7 nights. I'd even jump in carbonite to show you how I feel. I'd eat monkey brains for you. Did you know that I hate snakes too? And what do you see in Ally McBeal?
Take this from the start. What lies beneath is a random heart that I would take out of my chest for you. Like in the Temple of Doom, I'm jonesing for some Indiana, hoping, wishing, thinking, can a man like him fall for a girl like me?
Harrison Ford. Someone told me I should send him that song, but from what I gather in interviews, he seems like kind of a jerk, so I don't know if he'd appreciate it, so I'll just keep it to myself.
Okay.
Send it to Han Solo.
This next song is off of The Evidence. It's called Bayonets and Tourniquets. I seem to have written a song for pretty much every kind of state of my husband's sickness. And this one was kind of about losing faith in someone that you thought you had faith in.
The days unfold, calendar to fiscal year. Truth be told, I don't know the next part. I don't know this kind of fear. Wait for me. How could you have missed it? How could you have missed it? Just dismissed it.
Australia, and I went there for teachers college. So I told you in the first act that my partner decided to go out west to become a mountain biker. So I decided when he left, I just Googled teachers college Australia, and this man named Mike Johnson came up. And apologies if anyone knows Mike Johnson. I'm always worried when I'm telling this story. Someone's like, oh, that's my brother. So Mike Johnson is this man who lives in Christchurch, New Zealand. And he recruits Canadians to come over to Teachers College in Australia and New Zealand. So I Googled him, I Googled Teachers College Australia, and he came up. So I contacted him. And he called me within about an hour of this email, just asking to inquire about Teachers College. And he told me about this university called the Sunshine Coast, the University of the Sunshine Coast. Has anyone ever been to the Sunshine Coast of Australia? No? That's okay, I'll tell you about it. So the University of the Sunshine Coast, he explained it to me. He said, if you love snorkeling and surfing and the ocean, then you should go to the University of the Sunshine Coast. It's amazing. So I, of course, bought a ticket and gave him copious amounts of money to secure my spot as a teacher in training at the University of the Sunshine Coast. And I get there, and the campus is lovely, but it is very far from the beach. It's about an hour and a half drive from the actual beach. So I get there, and my roommate and I decided to write a song called Mike Johnson. And the chorus kind of goes like this.
You lied, you lied, you lied, Mike Johnson. You said it was the coast. It looks like Wisconsin, Mike Johnson. Oh dear, Mike Johnson.
So we wrote us like a rant song about Mike Johnson because it looked like Wisconsin. So I thought for my album, how could I change that? Change the lyrics, Mike Johnson, to kind of be a little bit more universal. So I wrote a song and I changed the lyrics to My Darling. Okay, so the lyrics are My Darling instead of Mike Johnson. But if you want to help me sing, maybe we'll do a fun verse at the end. You lied, you lied, you lied, Mike Johnson. You said it was the coast. It looks like Wisconsin, Mike Johnson. The actual lyrics are, this is the lyrics from the chorus.
You lied, you lied, you lied, my darling. You told me it was nothing. I knew that it was something, my darling. Oh dear, my darling.
So that's the new lyrics for the, but we might sing both, okay? So that's the actual lyrics, but you know that the secret lyrics are Mike Johnson. This is called My Darling. Johnson. Well, if it wasn't for Mike Johnson, I wouldn't have met my husband and become a teacher. So you know what? Some good did come from it.
Okay.
This song's called Poison.
start.
I'm going to mosey on over to the keys, so chat amongst yourselves for a couple seconds. How are we feeling?
Good.
Good?
Great. So, the album The Evidence has one cover on it. Every other song is my original. This cover is a song that my dad and I sing together. It's called Spoon River, and it's about a fictional city during the Civil War era. So it's kind of the one song on the album that doesn't really coincide with a cancer journey and with the concept, but it's got really sweet connotations for me. So this is Spoon River. It's a Steve Goodman tune. Let's liven this joint up a bit. This is I play a lot of my moonlight as a lounge singer in the evenings up in Orillia, at a lot of bars and restaurants. And this one seems to get a lot of turned heads, like, oh, I know that song, so I'm gonna give it a go. And if you know it, sing along.
Something I need, well, I
roller skates, you got a brand new key. I think that we should get together and find them on your seat. Been looking around a while, you got something I need. Oh, I got a brand new pair of roller skates, you got a brand new key. You recognize it? I ride my bike and roller skate, don't drive no car. Parentheses, the Vegemite song. Has anyone ever had Vegemite in here?
Yes.
Just an awful thing, isn't it? It's just awful.
Australian.
It's an Australian delicacy. Yes. If you haven't had it, it looks like Nutella, but it tastes the opposite. And it's this dark yeast vitamin B substance that they spread on toast, yes. And Aussies seem to love it. So my husband loves it. So I wrote a song called The chorus pretty much is, I would eat Vegemite for you. So it's called Divided by the Sea.
Divided by the
Yeah, maybe I should tweet Vegemite and see if maybe they want to put that on their latest slogan. Got a couple more tunes for you. I'm on this Canadian content kick right now. I'm going to sing another cover of one of my favorite singer-songwriters. I'm very much influenced by the work of Neil Young, so I thought maybe we could all sing a Neil Young song together. If you know it, sing along. Because I was driving in and the moon looked incredible today. Did anyone else notice that? Yeah.
Did Neil Young play last night in Kawartha
Lakes? Did he?
Yeah, he did a special concert last night.
Jeez, I should know that. I follow him on Twitter. I'm sure he's saying it.
It was a secret location, though, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a secret location. They weren't revealing it until like 4 o'clock in the afternoon.
Oh, that's so cool.
They rumored it was in Omimi.
Oh,
Oh, where he's from?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Cool. Well, I'm going to I'm gonna wrap up the evening with one last tune. This is from my first album. It's a Sublime song. And it features a kazoo solo, so bear with me. I just want to thank Andrew and Fariba for having me. This has been a lovely evening. Really, really warm, warm, friendly faces and an attentive audience. So thank you very much for having me. This song's called Santeria. My name's Steph Dunn. I have CDs available. You can come and say hello after the show. I need to do some last minute Christmas shopping. I don't practice Santeria. I ain't got no crystal.